Comedian Mark Steyn is a man of many trades, right-wing commentator, best-selling author, and he's even released an album honouring none other than our feline friends. Jess, exciting. He's currently in Australia on a whistle-stop tour. Please welcome Mark Steyn. Mark, thank you so much for joining us.
No, now, my pleasure.
You're a huge advocate of the freedom of speech. Do you think it should rule out everything else?
Yeah, I'm basically a great believer in absolute freedom of speech because I think the alternative is worse. This fuss about the basketball player that we've had in the last few days, essentially for going to a fancy dress party, you've got like a government official, the whatever it is, the Federal Race Commissioner, advising Australians on what's appropriate to go to a fancy dress party in. And I think that's very disturbing for 25-year-old people to be told by the government of Australia that they're mediating your fancy dress costumes. So I think the solution to the problem is actually worse than the problem.
But, Mark, what about the issue? And, you see, I love that you're a cat person, but I have to disagree with you so strongly on this particular issue because...
OK, well, freedom of speech is nothing compared to cats, so, like, you know...
because the... There was the basketball player, Liz Cambage, was very offended. She is of Nigerian descent. Right. She has been discriminated against because of her colour since she was a little girl. Her teammate dressed in blackface.
Right.
And people know how offensive blackface is.
Right.
And surely there has to be a balance between freedom of speech but not inciting someone to be... incite hate, racial discrimination. So that's where I have a real issue with your argument.
Well, she was there in blackface as Kanye West. You know, I've got no desire to go to a fancy dress party as Kanye West. The lady next to her was in whiteface. Nobody seems interested in what
that... Exactly.
Yeah, but it wasn't whiteface. That was from the Mexican, they have a festival of the dead.
Yeah.
So
she's gone as a dead white person.
No.
But she can't go as a live black
woman. No, but that would be like if you did that in the United States, they'd say that's cultural appropriation. You're appropriating Mexico's cultural tradition. Here we don't know what it is. I thought she was going as Heath Ledger as the Joker in Batman, or she was meant to be, Princess Kate or something. I had no idea. But the point is, you can't have a situation where one kind of face powder is bad and another kind of face powder is good, and you have a government commissioner weighing in on which face powder you're allowed to wear.
But it's not as simple as face powder. I mean, blackface has terrible connotations from America, and there are Indigenous Australians who are enormously offended by it too.
Right.
So it's not just simply face powder. I mean, it was used as a way of belittling African Americans, and surely we have to be.
Kanye West, her favourite singer? I don't think she meant to be.
This lady here,
she was a fan of his.
She was a fan of Kanye West. She's 25 years old. She's not a die-hard fan of 19th-century minstrel shows. There's nobody here who remembers 19th-century minstrel.
I do. We used to do the minstrels on Graham Kennedy's IMT.
And I'm an ex-showgirl. We used to do it in our
Right. But it hasn't been on. It hasn't been on television. Since what, the early 70s? Something like that.
Which is a good thing, though. Because we've got to move on from that.
I'm not advocating a return to minstrelsy. I'm advocating the right of a young lady to go to a costume party, get it wrong, come up with an insensitive costume costume, and then people say, wow, you really bombed with that lousy costume, but not to have her life destroyed by the media and by Federal Race Commissioner. The Federal Race Commissioner, there should not be a job like that because he exists to perpetuate racial grievance.
Nonsense. We need people like that to protect... people who've been discriminated against for so long. Can we go back to cats, though? I was showing you some photos before.
Let's go back to the cats.
I would also, just while we're on the topic, I would like to reassure Mark that, in fact, a faculty party at Sydney University with a Mexican theme was, in fact, cancelled because it was deemed to be racist against Mexicans.
Just before the cats, can I also make the point that we're talking about racism here, and we are all white people. Yeah. I mean, I do have a massive issue with that, because we can't talk from the point of why they are offended in a position of privilege.
You know as well as I do that by the standards of the world, Australia is not a... Australia in the year 2016 is not a hateful place.
I disagree.
You disagree?
I think there's a lot of hate in our community today.
It's changed. Really? I'm in show business, right? And I've had to change dialogue in my show because I'm politically incorrect. I don't believe in political correctness. I think it's gone too far. I think it's ruined this country. I think it's ruined our Australianism, if I can, if that's a word. But I have to change a dialogue in my comedy when I'm on stage because of racism. And you know, we used to be able to laugh at ourselves. We can't anymore.
Yeah. What would have happened to Al Jolson? That's what I want to know.
Yeah. Can we have a quick look at your clip singing the feline groovy song?
Okay.
Let's go to the cats.
Oh, yeah. I did. I saw a pussy cat as plain as he could be.
Right.
How fabulous.
Is very bad. He sneaks up from behind. Get it over there.
I don't think I would like it if I knew what's on his mind.
That is so cool.
That's great.
That's the old Looney Tunes song. Tweety used to, and Sylvester. Sylvester used to chase Tweety to it. I didn't want to do it in that. I tore a putty cat. So I happened to be in the car, and I heard Sting singing Every Breath You Take from the early 80s. And I thought, wait a minute. Sting stole this. From this is I thought I drew a putty. Yeah, there's Marvin, my cat, going through there. And I thought I drew a putty tat in the style of Sting doing Every Breath You Take, which is why we did a 1980s rock video.
Makes so much sense.
Yeah, it does make so much sense. You'd be surprised at the market for people who want to hear Looney Tunes cat songs done in the style of Sting. It's a huge market.
I don't agree with your politics, but I agree with your passion for cats.
Mark, thank you so much for joining us.
Cats can bridge the political divide.
Yeah. Thanks, Mark.